Today I'm going to show you how to make this simple interior in Blender. Okay, step one, model the room. Okay, first we're going to start by deleting everything in the scene. Next, we're going to press Shift A and add a cube. Then we're going to press G, Z and hold Control and bring the cube up so it's resting on the top of our scene. Then we're going to tab into edit mode. Then we're going to select a face. Then we're going to press G, X. And then we're just going to drag that cube along a bit and then click on the Move tab. Then we're going to type in 17 meters. Next, we're going to click on this face. Then we're going to press G, Y and drag it along a bit. Then we're going to head over to the Move tab and type in 24 meters. Then we're going to select the top face and press G, Z and drag it up a bit. Then we're going to type in 6.5 meters. And this is going to be our room. Next, we're going to select the top face and the bottom face. Then we'll press I to scale it in. Then we'll go over to the Insert Face tab and we'll type in 0.5 meters. Then we're going to right click and bridge the faces together. And now we're going to head over to Vertices Select Mode and then we'll select these four inner vertices. And then we'll press F to fill it in. And then we'll press P to separate it. Then we'll enable Snap to Vertices. Then we're going to select the floor and press Shift D. And then we'll snap it to our ceiling. Next, we're going to select everything. And then we're going to right click and select Origin. Then we're going to press Origin to Geometry. Now we're going to select the wall and tab into Edit Mode. Then we're going to click X-Ray. And then we're going to go into Face Select Mode by pressing Number Pad 3. Then we're going to select these two front faces and press X to delete. Then we're going to turn off X-ray mode and go back to Vertices Select. Then we're going to select these two vertices and get them to match the opposite edge. And then we'll press F to fill it in. And then we'll do the same on the other side. Then we'll select both the ceiling and the ground. Then we're going to tab into edit mode and match it up with the wall. Next, we're going to press Shift A and add another cube. Then we're going to snap that cube to the edge of the wall. Then we'll bring it up so it's sitting on top of the plane. Then we'll go back into edit mode and then we'll go into face select. And then we're going to get this cube to fit the entire length of our room. And then we'll select the back face and then we'll push it in by 1.5 meters. Then we're going to tab out of edit mode and then press Shift A and add a plane. Then we're going to press R, X, 90 and rotate the plane. Then we're going to bring it over here and then we'll snap it on top of the cube. Then we'll tab into edit mode and we're going to get the vertices to fill up this space and this will be our window. So we're now going to press A to select everything. And then we'll press E to extrude it out a bit. And then we'll type in 0.350 meters. Next, we'll go into face select mode, and then we'll select the front face and the back face, and then press I to extrude it in. And then we'll type in 0.25. And then we'll right click and press extrude face along normals. And we'll enter in minus 0.1. And then we're going to insert the face again, and then we'll enter in 0.15. And now we will bridge the two faces together. And this will be the outer frame of our window. Now we'll tab out of edit mode and press Shift A and add another plane. This is going to be our glass. So we're going to press R, X, 90. And then we're going to move it to the white position, tab back into edit mode, and then we'll move the vertices to fit our window. Okay, next we'll select everything again. And we'll press Ctrl A and apply scale to all objects in the scene. We'll also press Origin to Geometry again. Okay, next we're going to select the ceiling plane and we're going to tab into edit mode and we're just going to bring back these two front vertices so they're not overlapping the window. Then we're going to hide the ceiling plane and now we're going to add some detail to the side of the wall. So we're going to tab into edit mode, we're going to select loop cut, we're going to put one cut in the wall and we'll change the factor to 0.46. Then we're going to move into overhead mode and we'll zoom in on our loop cut and we're just going to fix it so our loop cut is straight. And now we're going to select our loop cut tool again and I'm going to add three more loop cuts and then we'll head over into edge select mode and we're going to turn back on X-ray mode and then we're going to select each cut individually and then we'll press Ctrl B to bevel it and then we'll change the bevel to about 0.05. And now we'll go into face select mode, and then we'll right click, and then we'll press extrude along normals. And we'll offset it by minus 0.075. Okay, now we're going to add a bit more detail to our scene. So we're going to press Shift A, add a cube, and we're just going to bring it next to this little detail that we've made in the wall. Then we're going to tab into edit mode, go into face select, and then we're just going to bring the cube up so it's the height of the wall. And then we're just going to push the cube in a bit, by about 0.75. Then we'll press A to select everything, and then we'll press Shift D to duplicate the cube. Then we're going to press RY90 to rotate the cube. And then we're just going to snap that to the top of the cube, and we're just going to extend it so it is the full length of the room. And that just adds a bit of detail to our room. Okay, next we're going to bring back the ceiling. And then we're just going to tap into edit mode, select the loop cut tool, and we're just going to add loop cuts to where our cube is overlapping with our ceiling. Then after we've done that, we're going to go into face select mode, and then we're just going to select this new face that we've made and press X and delete it. Then we're going to get the loop cut tool again, then we're just going to make a cut near the window. Then we'll press Ctrl B to bevel it, and then we'll go into face select mode, and we're just going to extrude this face a bit. And we're just going to extrude it by 0.25. Now that we've made the basic layout of our scene, let's add a camera. So press Shift A and add a camera. And then we're just going to set this camera up to the right position where we want it to be looking at. After we've done that, we're going to go over to our camera setting, then we're going to play around with the clipping until we can clearly see our room. Then we're going to turn up our pass part out so we can just see our camera view. Then we're just going to play around with our camera's location until we get the view that we're looking for. And I think I'll just bring back the focal length a bit. I might play around with the camera's location a bit more. And that's pretty much it. Now we're ready to move on to the next step. Step 2, light the scene. Okay, before we start lighting the scene, we're going to head over to the shader editor. We're going to select the window glass, and we're going to give it a glass material. We're doing this now so that we can have light enter into our room. Okay, now let's add the lights. So we're going to press Shift A, add an area light. We're going to move this area light so it's facing the window. We're going to bring it up a bit. We'll scale it out. We'll move it to the right position. We'll double tap R so that we can rotate it to look at the room. Then we're going to go over to the area light settings. Then we'll change the shape of it to a disc. We'll change the power of the light to 285. And we'll change the color to a light yellow. Then we're going to add another light into our scene. We'll move it to the right position. We'll go into top view. And then we'll scale it out. Then we'll scale it out on the Y axis. And then once we have it in the white position, we'll go over to the light settings. We'll change the color to yellow again, and then we'll change the power to 100. Then we'll go into camera view, and then we'll go into material preview. Then we'll go into world settings. Then we're going to change the color to environment texture. Then we're going to open up wherever we saved our HDRI, and this will be the background for our render. Then we'll head back to the shader editor, change it from object to well. We'll go back into camera view, then we'll go into render view, and then with node wrangler enabled, we're going to press Ctrl T, and we're now going to change the rotation of the HDRI, and we'll change it to minus 212. Then we'll bring back the ceiling, change the render engine from EV to cycles, and now that's pretty much the lighting part of our scene done. And we can move on to the next step. But before that, real quick, if you're enjoying the video, why not leave a like? And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Step 3, add materials to the room. Okay, first we're going to start by selecting the floor. Then we're going to go over to material properties. We're going to select the wooden floor texture. Then we're going to select the wall, add a new material. We'll change the subsurface to 1.6. And we'll change the specular to 0.6, and the roughness will be 0.55, and then we'll make the color a bit of a yellowy orange. Then we might bring down the saturation just a bit, and then we'll make the subsurface color a bit darker and give the color a bit more saturation. Now we're also going to give the little detail in the wall its own material. So we're going to tab into edit mode, we're going to change the face select, turn on X-ray mode, we'll go into top view, then we'll select the detailed part of the wall. After we've done that, we're going to add a new material and we're going to assign that material to this part of the wall. We're going to make it a bit metallic, then we're going to change the roughness to 0.3, and that's the material pretty much done. I might bring up the metallic to 0.2, and then we'll give this cube pillar the same material as the wall. We'll also do the same for the windowsill wall. We'll also unhide the ceiling and give it that material too. Then we'll go back into camera view, then we'll turn off X-ray mode, then we'll go into render preview, and this is what we've got so far. And that's materials pretty much done. We can move into the final step. Step 4, fill the room with stuff. For the models we're going to use in the scene, you can find them in the link in the description below. To bring the models into the scene, we're going to go over to File, we're going to click Append, we're going to find where we saved the Blender file, we're going to click Collection, and then we're going to click Collection again, and now our assets are in our scene. Most of these assets are from Sketchfab, which you can go to and find your own if you want, and then some of them I made myself, which you can also do if you want. Okay, now let's put them into the room. Before I start putting models into the room, I'm going to select the camera. Then we're going to play around with the focal length so we have a better view of the room. Next, I'm going to play around with the camera's location again to get it looking just right. Okay, now let's start bringing in the models. Okay, first I'm going to start with the rug and I'm going to bring it in and align it up with the camera. So next I'm going to bring in the sofa, so I'm going to click the sofa and drag it in. And we'll move it to the right position, might scale it down a bit. And I might rotate it a bit so it's facing the camera. Now let's see how it's looking in camera view. Okay, that's looking pretty good, and let's bring in the next model. Okay, next I'm going to bring in the two sofa chairs, so I'll start with this one. Okay, now I'm just going to rotate and move around the two sofas until I get them in the right position. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now let's bring in the other chair. So we're going to select it and move it in. Scale it down. Give it a bit of a rotate. And we'll continue to move it about until we get it in the right position. Then we'll go into camera mode. We'll move around the chairs and the sofa a bit more. Okay, that looks good. Let's bring in the next couple of models. Next, we're going to select the wooden table and we'll move it into the scene. And we'll just keep moving around the table until we get it in the white spot. Now let's bring in the small table into the scene. Once we've done that, let's start bringing in the plants. So we'll bring the first plant behind the sofas and the second one in front of the window. Then next I'll bring in the two paintings. Then next we'll bring in the curtain. Then once we have the curtain in the scene, we're going to fit it so that it fits into the little detail that we made in the ceiling. So we'll bring the detail a bit closer to the curtain. Then we'll scale it out a bit more. Once we've done that, let's go see how it looks in camera view. Bring it across a bit, and that's the curtain in the scene. Okay, next let's bring in the smaller objects. So I'll bring in the books first. Next I'll bring in the small plant. Then I'll bring in the little cup of tea. Then I'll bring in the little plant and the ornament at the back. And then the last thing we'll add is the ceiling light. So we'll change the rotation to -180. Then we're going to move it into our scene. Once we have it in our scene, we're going to move it around the ceiling until we get it in the right position. Once we've done that, we're going to press Shift A and add another light. And then we'll press Shift A again and add another one. And then we're just going to move them around until we get them in the right position. Once we've done that, we're going to select all three lights and duplicate them. and we're just going to get them into the white position. Okay, now that we've got all the models in the scene, we're now going to do the last finishing touches. So we'll go back into Enter Preview mode. Then first we'll select the room light. We'll go over to light settings. We're going to change power to 125. Then we'll select the other light and we'll change its power to 290. And once we've done that, we'll head back to camera view. We'll turn back on scene world and scene light. Then we'll turn back on the ceiling and head over to camera settings, where we'll open up color management and we'll change look to medium contrast. Then we'll head over to world settings and we'll change strength to 1.5. Next, we'll go to output properties. Then we'll click on the little folder icon. Then we'll find a place for the render to be saved. Then we'll go to render properties and we'll change samples to 300. And that's pretty much it. Now we're ready to render out the image. So we'll go over to render and we'll click render image. And that's how you make a realistic interior in Blender. I hope you've enjoyed the video and learned something today, and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.